Welcome back to the Steve Gruber Show. Good to have you along for the conversation today. Remember, you can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. If you want to find out more, you can also drop me a line at stevegruber.com. Ask me a question. I'll do my very best to answer that or read it on the air, whatever is appropriate. And if you want to hear a podcast of previous programs or interviews, you can do that at stevegruber.com as well. So if, for example, you hear today's interview and you say, gosh, that was great information, and you want to go back and hear it again, you go to stevegruber.com to make that happen. And the reason I say that is because our next guest, Dr. Rebecca Wolfe, is a member of the Sparrow Family Practice Team at the Sparrow Medical Group North. Doctor, welcome to the program.
Thank you.
So tell me this, what is family practice? When I hear that term, what does that mean?
So in the old days, you had a GP who was the town doctor, and they realized that there needed to be more training to get into modern medicine, so they developed a residency. So we're board certified in taking care of the whole family from birth on through to the end of life.
And when you talk about that, you create an institutional knowledge. And I bring this up because just recently I was talking to a family member, a cousin, who was having some medical issues. I said, well, who's your family doctor? I don't really have one. And I'm thinking, you know, I had a family doctor who has since passed that delivered me, right, brought me into the world and was around until he retired. And I was in my mid-20s, but that had gotten me through so many phases of my life and challenges and difficulties because you have an institutional knowledge. You go back and say, gee, Steve, this happened when you were 10 and this happened when you were 20. And so they have a base of knowledge. Is that a really important thing?
It is important. And not only do I have a base of knowledge for the individual, and I do have patients that I delivered, so I don't do deliveries any longer. And they're all off to college now, so that's pretty fun to watch that. But I also take care of their parents. Sometimes I take care of their grandparents. They go off and have their own families. I take care of their kids. So I can sometimes know cousins and extended families, which helps me not just with their philosophy of life, their philosophy of care, but also obviously with the family history as well.
Which is important. If a family has a predisposition to, say, breast cancer, you know that. You would know that the cousins and the family, and even though you don't deliver anymore, you still meet these people oftentimes when they're very little, don't you?
Right. Day four usually is when I get to see them. So not only does it help me know their medical history, but it also gives me an idea of what their fears or hopes might be around those diseases so that I can help them negotiate the medical system in a way that makes sense for them as individuals.
Sure. If a family has a history of heart disease and you see somebody in that family that's, you know, 20, 30, 40, 50 pounds overweight, you can say, you know, this might not be a good path for you. And you can be however gentle you need to be about that to sell that conversation, right?
That's exactly right.
Right.
I'm a physician, but I'm also an educator, and you know, sometimes I'm a marketer as well.
Yeah. Sometimes you're a counselor, an expert, a doctor, a friend. You're all of those things at one point or another in your career, aren't you?
I am.
Yeah. So I understand you guys just received a major national award based on patient feedback about your care. Tell me about that.
So the organization Professional Research Consultants puts out surveys to patients to see how they think their care is. And one of the questions they ask is, do you think your doctor is doing an excellent job taking care of your overall care? And are you satisfied when you go to the doctor that they listen to you, take time with you, and give you the very best care? So I was honored to receive that award. They choose the physicians around the country that got the top rankings on that, and I'm quite honored. Honestly, it comes from the patients thinking that they are getting what they need, and so that is a very special thing for me.
That is a very special thing. When it comes from the people that you talk to, treat, and deal with on a daily basis, and they say, yes, she's the best, that's got to be humbling and flattering all at the same time.
It is. I'm quite humbled by it. And, you know, I have long-standing relationships with these people, so it makes me feel like they are getting what they need when they come to the doctor, and I really appreciate that.
So let me ask you this. Obviously, where you work at Sparrow Medical Group North, you're obviously the doctor for these patients, but you have a whole team around you, nurses, physician assistants, all sorts of people that work in that family, in that team. How important is that team when you go to work every day?
So we make the culture here. I work with wonderful colleagues, wonderful clinical and front staff. And you know, the person that greets you when you walk in the room is just as important as all of us in making sure that you know you belong here, that this is your medical home, that you're part of something that when you need help, you can come to us to get that. And so we work really hard to make sure that we all communicate with each other and that we all bring that same emphasis on patient care and patient compassion. We try not just to do, obviously, the best evidence-based medicine, but also to make people feel that they belong here and that someplace they'd want to come.
I think that's the most impressive line I've heard today. We make the culture here. I do. I think that says a lot. We make the culture here. And it's from the time you walk in, because oftentimes, whether they're patients you've known for a long time or they're a new patient walking through the door, many times they're frightened, as you mentioned. They're coming in because something's not going right in their life and they're concerned about a medical condition that could be life-altering. So that first person to meet them at the door and from that point forward is critical to how that patient feels. And you know this, it's often a state of mind as to how you battle an illness if you're going to be successful or not, right?
That's correct.
Yeah, so
that's
when you make the culture, that's critical. Dr. Rebecca Wolfe here, a family, a board-certified Sparrow Family Practice doctor at the Sparrow Medical Group North. Let me ask you this. How important is this patient-friendly approach to you as you go forward in your career?
So when I first came into medicine, you know, we were trained to tell the patient what they needed to do, and sometimes they did it and sometimes they didn't. And what I've learned over the years, like many of us, is that the people that we work with have a lot to say about what they need, and patients have those same needs. They know what medicine that they want to take and which ones they don't want to take. And if I just hand them a pile of prescriptions, the chance that they are going to fulfill all that is pretty limited. But when I include them in understanding why they have the disease they have, sometimes we don't know,
right,
what it means to them, what they can anticipate in the future, and why these medications or why this test or why this specialist is important in helping them stay well and getting better, the chance that they'll follow through on that is excellent, especially if we decide together that, you know, one approach is better than another approach. And so now we're on the same team.
And doctor,
now we are working on this together.
I can see why you are so successful at what you do. You're just very good at explaining things. If people want to find out more, how do they do that?
So we have a website that at Sparrow, and we also have a 1-800 number, 1-800-SPARROW, and you can find physician referrals at that location as well as community programs.
Dr. Rebecca Wolfe, you have been absolutely terrific. Greatly appreciate your time from the Family Medicine Group at the Sparrow Medical Group North. Doctor, thank you so much.
Thank you for your time. Have a good day.